This video will describe in detail how to perform the CPE or home cert step of the home certification auto test program. This is the test that would be performed at the primary outlet in the house. Typically this includes a full channel plan scan, maybe a limited channel plan scan, a measurement of MER, possibly BER on a few digital channels, carrier to noise possibly on some analogs, a modem test, in other words I'm checking the downstream and upstream levels of my modem. All these measurements can be created, combined into one auto test, and that is typically part of the home certification process. Let's take a look at the meter and I'll show you exactly how to do this. First, if we go to the auto test menu, we'll select the job. I want to create a new job. Okay, just hit enter if you're prompted for an okay. In my case, I'm using a 6-digit task ID, so I'm going to create a 6-digit job number. You'll notice I have the job listed here. It's open, which means I can save data to it. Zero tests. I haven't run any tests yet. And the channel plan is Office B in this case. Just as a tip, you'll want to make sure that the meter is set to the correct channel plan before I create the job. If it's not, just back out, go to the level mode, put the meter on the correct channel plan, then go back into jobs, create your job. Once I've created, I can hit the back button. And then from my auto test menu, I'll run the home cert test. Like I said, this is known as home cert, CPE, set top sometimes. It's performed at the primary outlet. In this meter, I can run it at different locations, but I'm required to run it at the outlet. I'm going to start this test, and typically the auto test that you run at the primary outlet will last about 3 to 4 minutes in most cases. In my case, I'm measuring the signal levels on a few digitals, a few analogs. I'm measuring carrier to noise on an analog. I'm measuring MER on a few digitals, and then I'm firing up the modem, and I'm measuring downstream and upstream on the modem. To do all these things, it can take several minutes. The whole idea behind creating the auto test is I want to find out as much information as I can, but I don't want the technician sitting there for 20 minutes waiting for the test to run. So it's kind of a trade-off. The things that add time to the test are, of course, the cable modem. The cable modem can take a minute and a half typically to boot up and get online. Also, if I'm measuring MER and BER on several digitals, that can add some time because the meter actually has to sit on that channel for several seconds to be able to count the bits, if you will. You know, actually measure the bits coming in. Right now, I'm at the stage where my cable modem is booting up. This, like I said, typically takes about a minute and a half. So let's jump ahead for the purposes of this video to the end of this test. Okay, the cable modem test just finished. You'll see I have a green check on my levels. I have a green check on my DOCSIS now, which tells me these steps in my auto test have passed. The ingress was not run here. The ingress is a different test in the home certification process. There's another video on it. The meter's going to ask me, do I want to save the test results? I'm going to say okay. It will save it to the job number, and then as I back out, do I want to close this job? If I'm finished with this job, the answer is yes. I'll close the job out. If I go back into the jobs menu, you can see this job is now closed. I have one auto test saved to it. If that's all that's required for my home certification process, I'm finished.